I see you, champion. Sit, please.
You shouldn't miss this chance to trade.
A caravan of Asura make camp in the still sands south of here. We've tolerated them so far. But their leader's a greedy profiteer. He steps out of line, I'll gladly send the whole camp packing.
That's fair enough. Sounds like the Asura are taking quite a risk being up. Maybe I should talk to them. Find out what they're doing.
Oh, Aloy. Your Karja friend came through. She went to that Asuram camp you two were looking for, to the southwest. Aloy!
Sorry, I didn't mean to startle you. You sure you're okay being alone in here?
I have Gaia. And learning how to interpret the glyphs of the old ones, it keeps me occupied.
Have you gone back to Plainsong at all?
I thought about it, but I wouldn't know what to tell them. The chorus already thinks me a thorn in the thicket. If they knew what we did to Fa, even if they understood, there'd be little they could grasp about all this. No. For now, I must leave the tribe behind.
I've been meaning to ask, what's the deal with you and the chorus? You didn't seem to be on the best of terms.
That's what happens when you're the one Utaru who insists on publicly defying them. Twice. When the Karja invaded the Utaru Plains, they did more than just attack our villages. They burned our fields, took our people as slaves, and murdered those who were too weak to make the trip back to Meridian.
To be sacrificed in the Sun Ring.
I was helping the healers back then, as waves of refugees swarmed into Plainsong. The chorus was divided in how to face the invaders. Some saw sense in raising arms. Others believed the dishes would keep us safe, as they had many times before. And while they bickered, I buried the seeds of the fallen.
It couldn't have been easy, seeing your people suffer while the Karja invaded your lands.
I come from a small village near Plainsong. My grandmother used to say there was no seed that wouldn't grow there. I moved to the dishes when I decided to apprentice as a healer. When the Red Raids began, I thought about going back. But the injured kept pouring into Plainsong, day after day. So I kept putting it off. One day, I woke up to hear a Karja raiding party had ransacked my village during the night. I rushed there with the healers to help the survivors, but there weren't any left. The smell of burning flesh haunts me to this day.
I'm sorry, Zo.
I made it a point to appear before the chorus as soon as we returned. to demand that we take a stand against the invaders. I was denied. So I left to fight on my own.
You said you set out to fight the Karja alone?
I did. But it turned out I wasn't the only one. News of my disagreement with the chorus spread through the plains. Before I knew it, I had more than a dozen Utaru warriors ready to follow me into battle. We knew we couldn't take on the Karja armies head-on, but we also knew the lay of the land better than they did. We ambushed smaller raiding parties, sabotaged their supply lines, and hit their encampments at night.
Sounds like you were a force to be reckoned with.
Enough that the Tanakh took notice. When the clans began to push the Karja back east, they let us join their ranks. We chased the enemy all the way to Barren Light.
You said you were at Barren Light when the Tanakh defeated the Karja?
Tanakh marshals climbed the cliffs of the Daunt under cover of night, then attacked from the other side. Before we knew it, the gates were open, and the full force of the clans burst through. What happened next was not something I like to remember. When all the dust and blood settled, I smelled it again. The stench of burnt flesh. Our enemies defeated. What was left of my squad returned to the Utaru Plains. I went back to Plainsong. But even as the harvest passed, it didn't feel like I'd truly returned at all.
Is that when you became a gravesinger?
I thought soothing the suffering of others would somehow appease my own. Then you came along and gave me a choice. I could either sing at people's graves or fight for a chance to keep them alive.
I'm glad you chose the latter. So, how does a tribe like the Utaru manage to maintain the peace with warriors like the Tanakh?
By holding them off. When our fields bloomed aplenty, the Tanakh looked upon our lands with envy. But Plainsong's dishes provided sanctuary and high ground to keep invaders at bay. In the end, even the Tanakh saw sense in a truce. The Utaru promised to provide the Tanakh with food from our crops every year. In exchange, the Tanakh would relinquish one of their own, a veteran, to train the Utaru in combat. This custom was abandoned a few years after the derangement, but some veterans still remain in the plains.
Did Gaia tell you anything about the Zeniths?
She did, though it wasn't exactly easy to believe. To think that there are places among the stars where life can bloom as it does here, it is humbling, to say the least. And heartbreaking, that such life should be bent on destroying ours.
You mentioned you've been teaching yourself how to read?
Yes. Gaia was kind enough to put together a list of glyphs used by the old ones. She helped me decipher some of the data you've collected, and showed me how to use the focus to help the process. It's not easy, but it's been working so far.
That's good to hear. Sounds like you met my friend Talana.
Yes. The Karja Huntress. I haven't seen armor like hers since the Red Raids. But Varl tells me that she too suffered at the hands of the Mad Sun King.
Yeah. She's one of the good ones. Trust me. So you've been talking to Gaia?
Yes. She was kind enough to take me through some of the history of the Old Ones, including their demise and the heroic actions of her creator, Elizabeth Sobek. I was surprised to see she was you. Past, but reborn? Not that I claim to understand how.
I need to go. But if you need anything, you can contact me through your focus.
I'll keep that in mind.
X-Wing's holding up. The snow brought the chill. Should hit it with frost ammo. An image of the old world. Huh. That looks like plain song. And some kind of metal structure. I'll save this for a dire. Did it? heard I'd find them here. Getting rid of their leader might cause the rest to leave. Weak against shock.
More to fire.
Fear leaves a trail, and I'll find it. Anything yet?
You will be
She's
found.
She's not getting out of this! Keep searching!
Judging by that armor, I think I know who's in charge.
Show yourself!
I can get out of this.
Any luck there?
No luck. You?
I'm not letting her go!
I can smell you out there!
Tugs.
She's gone to ground!
I have to figure out what to do with them later. Without a leader, the rebels should abandon this place. But I could always deal with them now. Either way, I'm down here.
I see her! Target the Outlander!
The area should be safe now. They've got machines in here. I could override them and set them free. Stir up some trouble. Stop looking already. These rebels won't be bothering anyone else. This guy won't be causing any more trouble. I'm green shine too often. An An ancient rail cart. Huh. I wonder if it can still move. What does this switch do? Looks like this switch controls the tracks. Okay. As far as it goes. Be useful. Interesting. This could help. Looks like this door needs some kind of key module to open. Better search the ruin. Key module. Perfect. Going down! There we go. This needs a code. I think I found some data in the ruin that might help. I'm in. Okay. Where to now? Tracks are lined up with the curve side now. Made it. Okay, got the relic. I'll hold on to it for now. Figure out what to do with it later. Okay. This green shine will fetch a price.
I think I can live right here.
through those. Busy filling up the canisters on the backs. This green shine for later. She won't be bothered by acid. Break my fall. You